Hi guys, this is Shijie from Tidal Robotics. In this video, I will go over the basics of PID tuning in the Python API with our flight scan. Note that tuning the PID coefficients on the simulated hardware is possible, but more difficult. This is because our simulated hardware does not yet have inertia, which means the rotation speed reacts instantly to throttle changes. This makes closed-loop control algorithms like PID more challenging to handle. In a nutshell, a PID controller is a special algorithm that aims to keep a specific sensor at a specific value. The PID controller achieves this by continuously calculating the required throttle output to make your propulsion system converge to the desired sensor value. For example, if you want to achieve a constant 5 kg of thrust, but the thrust is currently 4 kg, the PID controller will increase the throttle. If the PID controller increases the throttle too much, a few seconds later, the thrust could be 6 kg. Above the target of 5. This is called overshoot, and essentially it means the PID controller reacted too strongly. This is the whole concept behind PID tuning, which is to ensure the control response is appropriately quantified to efficiently reach the desired target. In this video, we will be focusing on thrust. We will set a relatively low set point of 2.5 newtons for our demonstration purposes, but in reality, this would likely be much higher. To get started, you will first need to be able to successfully run the first example.py file in the repository. If you have not yet done so, we highly recommend that you watch these videos first. You will need to install certain packages in order to run this PID example. Assuming you are able to run the first example, open the flight scan software and PyCharm. We will open a console and check we have simple PID installed. Simply run this command. We will need to know the number corresponding to the signal for thrust. To find this, open the .proto file in the repository and scroll down until you see the list of input signals. You will see that thrust, FZ, corresponds to type 11. Next, open example 4. We need to change the input and output signals to match with our flight stand. The input board should match the board in the software as well as the output board. Run the Python file. You should see the terminal output a list of available inputs. Find the one corresponding to type 11, and enter that in after the target input board. For us, the thrust signal is 3. Here, we will change the target value to 2.5. This is in SI units, so in this case, newtons. The period is set to 10 seconds, meaning it will complete one cycle every 10 seconds. The set point is in SI units. Thus, whenever you perform a PID test, make sure the units are correct. We set our set point to 2.5 newtons. For our initial KPKI and KD values, we will use 0, 30, and 0. When we run the test, we can see the flight stand react accordingly. We can now change our KP, KI, and KD values to try to optimize the test. Next, we will try with a KI value of 50. When we execute the file, we should expect to see the flight stand cycle between 2.5 and 1.25 newtons on a 10-second interval. The KI term is a constant that is multiplied by the integral of the error. The product is then added to offset the error. We can try adding a small KD term of 5. The KD term, like the integral term, is a constant that we multiply by the derivative of the error. The transient time seems a bit long, so we can try adding a KP term of 50. The proportional term is similar to the integral and derivative terms, but is simply just the product of the error and the constant. It seems to dampen the response before reaching the set point, so let's try increasing KP and KI to 80. Now there is overshoot, so let's decrease the KP turn back to 50. Now we have a better PID response. PID controllers can be tuned to near perfection, and this is just for demonstration purposes. In practice, you can tune it to be much better. For more information on PID controllers and how they work, I recommend watching this video. The link is in the description. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. If you enjoyed this tutorial or found it helpful, make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.